दिस इज़ द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ लेक्चर वन. आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू अबाउट द सिलिकॉन इनगॉट्स एंड वेफर्स एंड ऑल्सो शोन यू अ रेक्टेंगुलर सबस्ट्रेट ऑफ थिकनेस अबाउट 200 माइक्रोमीटर विच वी विल रिक्वायर टू फैब्रिकेट द मोनोलिथिक आईसी. As you have seen in the previous slide, how the silicon ingots look and how a silicon bowl or ingot is cut into thin slices or wafers and then polished before use. Though the dimension of the wafer varies depending on which type of device we actually want to fabricate, this wafer is used as a substrate. The cutting of silicon ingots into slices or wafers is done by using diamond cutter, and it is only done after knowing the particular crystal orientation. As you know, silicon has a particular crystal structure. It is silicon is a has a diamond cubic structure. So when cut into wafers, the surface is aligned to one of several relative directions. That is the crystal orientation. This is a very important point we always have to keep in mind. Generally, crystal orientation of silicon is found to be 100 or 111. These are the Miller indices of the particular type of crystal. Though it is not in your course, so I am not discussing this part so much elaborately. So the point is that you have to cut the wafers into pieces in the dimensions which you require for IC fabrication. After the cutting process, when we obtain the substrate, in this case we are considering a rectangular substrate as I have shown you in the previous slide. The main process which we have to start with is the cleaning of the wafer. Cleaning of the wafer is the primary step for the IC fabrication process. It is mainly done to remove the adhered impurities from the wafer or substrate surface. Wafer cleaning process. Different types of cleaning techniques have been developed in the past. In this case, I will illustrate one of the most commonly used technique. But before that, we have to understand what are the main objectives of this wafer cleaning process. The first objective you can see here is the removal of organic contamination. That is, when you are getting a wafer or a slice over which you have to fabricate an IC, the first and the primary process is you have to clean the wafer before using it for IC fabrication. That is, the wafer may be in the contaminated form. The impurities may have been incorporated on the wafer surface from the deposition technique or the process from which the crystal has been made, or during the sawing technique or during the cutting technique. So the contaminations may be of different types. The contaminations may be organic, the contamination may be metallic or ionic, the contamination may be native oxide type. So there are different types of contaminations that may come on the wafer surface. Apart from this, we should use in our labs, when we are using the beakers, we should use the vessels or beakers in which we will keep the chemical reagents that will be used for IC fabrication. Those vessels or beakers should be of quartz or Teflon or polypropylene, but not essentially glass, because glass contains ions and these ions may may be incorporated in the wafer, which may contaminate the wafer. Besides this, the water which we have to use for the deposition for the IC fabrication process should be deionized. That is, should not contain any ions. As you know, that the water we drink contains different types of ions, different minerals, but the deionized water essentially does not contain such ions or any minerals. So it is sometimes called dead water. Okay, it should not be used for drinking. Now you can see here, it is written here, with the resistivity of the water should be high, because if the water's resistivity is not high, then it will not be able to resist the appearance of contamination in the water from any sources. So essentially, what the resistivity range we use is in the range of 12 to 18 mega ohm centimeter. Besides this, all the reagents and chemicals which will be used for IC fabrication should be ultra pure and ultra filtered, because if it is not in the pure form, if it is not filtered before using, then this may also add impurities on the wafer surface. Though different types of cleaning techniques have been developed in the past, however, in this lecture, I will illustrate one of the most commonly used ones, and that technique is RCA technique, which is named after the company's name who developed it. The name of the company is RCA Corporation. It is a cleaning method which can be used to remove the organic residue or contaminants from the silicon wafer surface. The cleaning solution which is used for this purpose is made up of 5 parts of water, 1 part of 30% dilute hydrogen peroxide solution, and 1 part of 27% dilute ammonia solution. As you know, when ammonia reacts with water, H2O, it forms ammonium hydroxide. That is, in this case, we have to use 27% solution of ammonium hydroxide. RCA cleaning process is an effective technique or an effective way to remove the organic or metallic or ionic contaminants from the wafer surface. And after the cleaning process, it leaves behind a thin layer of oxidized silicon on the surface of the wafer, which actually protects the wafer from further contamination. This RCA cleaning process can be carried out in 2 different steps. The first step is the standard clean 1, SC1 step, and the second step is the standard clean 2, SC2 step. Here you can see SC1 clean process uses the ammonium hydroxide hydrogen peroxide water mixture. That is the mixture of the 2 chemicals, ammonium hydroxide and hydrogen peroxide, which removes the organic particles from the wafer surface. Due to the chemical reactions of these reagents, this forms a thin layer of silicon dioxide on the wafer surface with some metallic contaminants or metallic contamination on the wafer surface that will be removed in the subsequent SC2 step. SC2 cleaning method. This method uses a solution that is made up of 6 parts of deionized water, 1 part of hydrochloric acid, and 1 part of hydrogen peroxide. These steps actually removes remaining traces of metallic or ionic contaminants from the wafer surface. And most of these contaminants, that is metallic or ionic contaminants, were introduced in the SC1 cleaning step. In addition, this SC2 cleaning step leaves behind a thin passivation layer on the wafer surface that actually protects the wafer surface from subsequent or any other further contamination. After this cleaning technique, the silicon wafer is ready for further processing. I would like to mention here that however we have used this RCA cleaning technique, but we may have to use the other cleaning techniques too in order to remove the other types of contaminations like native oxide contamination, as I already told you. That is, it is one of the important contaminations, or any other greasy impurities from the wafer surface. But the elaborate discussion on cleaning technique is not in your course. So far, you have to just understand the importance of the wafer cleaning. That is, we should have to clean the wafer before using it for IC fabrication process. In my next lecture, I will discuss the steps of monolithic IC fabrication process. But before listening to the next video lecture, you have to understand all the topics, all the features that I have told you about microelectronics and IC technology. I hope you have understood. Okay, thank you.